Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. I'm trying to get my schedule worked out. The Lord has spoken to me to get back down there to Houston, Katy, and all up through there, all the way up to Dallas. See, brothers and sisters in Dallas, a Little Rock again in that area, by the grace of God, and all points in between. Brothers and sisters, I'm ready to go. I've been refreshed by the Lord to do it. You know, I was ready to you know, settle down and not do it, but the Lord said, no, I want you to go. That's a rhyme, in case you didn't catch it in time. It's another one. The Lord wants to send revival. Now, that's what the Lord wants to bring in the last harvest, and it takes the Spirit of the Lord to move. Sister Texine, as you and I know, sister, the Lord wants to send revival by land and by sea. From every means possible, the Lord wants to send revival to His already pre-chosen, predestined people. The Lord knows who they are, and we don't. You know, it's, you know, people talk about a revival. There's different kinds of revivals, you know, different forms where the Lord moves within certain groups of people. He moves within, you know, like among drunks. He moves among prostitutes. He moves among drug addicts. He moves among, you know, in prisons. Sometimes he moves everywhere. But the Lord is just telling me right now that the prisons are the churches. You know, it's just like in Acts chapter 4 and verse and chapter 5, you know, where the Sanhedrin told the apostles, hey, don't preach anymore in that name. You know, you can do whatever you want. Just don't use that name. They wouldn't even say His name. They wouldn't say the name of Jesus. And that's when, you know, the apostles said, it wasn't Peter, but one of the apostles said, hey, you know, judge for yourself. Well, it had to be John. He was the other one standing there. He said, judge for yourself. Should we obey you or God? You know, so that's the big question. You know, that's why, brothers and sisters, I'm so dangerous. And people like me are so dangerous to the established religious people. They don't want nobody coming in, rocking the boat and shaking things up like Jesus did, like the apostles did. You know, Peter and John, they said that the Sanhedrin observed that they were unlearned men. But yet, they had been with Jesus. Even they said that about Jesus. How does this man know letters? He's never been to, you know, he's never been to theological seminary, but he already knew letters. He was, you know, he knew the stuff, but hadn't been through their schooling. How is it? That's why people are so shook up when the Spirit of the Lord moves. God comes in and turns everything upside down, all the religion of men. You know, it's so funny that you talk about duality. Some of my viewers are dualists. You know, they live in a religious world. But they like to hear good preaching, and the things seem to be a collision amongst good preaching, anointed preaching by the Spirit of God. The move of the Spirit of God is enmity to the religious spirit. There's lots of people that's called in between. Tons of people tell me, well, you know, I like my church, and my pastor's a nice guy, but he just don't really, he just want to grow the church and not step on people's toes. You know, he won't really preach the truth, only part of the truth, or none of the truth, instead of the whole truth and nothing but the truth. That's why it's dangerous to the kingdom of darkness. That's why the devil hates revival, because it brings chaos to his kingdom. It brings God's order. God's order is not our order. People, that's why all these religious people hate speaking in tongues, because it's not order. They can't control it. They don't know what's going on. That's why they say, you need an interpreter, you need an interpreter, you need an interpreter. Instead of saying, hey, where's the interpreter? Why am I not interpreting? Why am I not speaking in tongues? They want to, hey, simmer down now, tongue speaker. We'll get the ushers to ask you to leave. You just might wake somebody up. Shh, don't wake us up. We're sleeping here. The pastor has rocked us to sleep. And we missed the visitation of the Lord, because we've been building our own kingdom. We've been making our own way here. Don't disturb us. Don't mess us up. We got our own representative of Christ here. We've got our own vicar of Christ. We've got our own, you know, sometimes even in this Church of England, they call it the preacher to vicar, you know. And then there is the vicar of Christ, the Pope of Rome. Hey, we've got our own spokesman here. You know, when I first got in the ministry, I used to, you know, watch even EWTN. They started having it on cable. The Catholic Network, and they have a show on there called Journey Home. And it's a guy who was a Presbyterian that, you know, became a Catholic, and he has people in there that were Presbyterian, whatever, preachers, and they became a Catholic. They always say the same thing. They want order. They want discipline. They want a box. They want a church to have authority over them. They want to be under the dominion of a man. Just like with Moses, you know, the people, God wanted to talk to the people, and then they went up, they were so afraid and ran back. They said, we don't want to talk to God anymore. No, 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 no. God wanted to make them a kingdom of priests. God wanted to make them all kingdoms of priests and a holy nation. But they would not have it. No, 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 no. They were afraid. They said, Moses, we ain't talking to God no more. You go talk to him, Moses, and then come back and tell us what he said. We want a mediator with God. A man to be a mediator. But what did God do? He came along when B.C. was changed to A.D. and he sent forth his only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth, the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh, who dwelt among us. And he is the only mediator, the Bible says. There's one mediator between God and man, that's the man Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the only mediator. But what religion tells you, that you need another mediator, that we, the church, or the pastor, the leader, is the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father but through them, through their sacraments, through their ceremonies, through their certificates. No one can preach unless we ordained you. Now, brothers and sisters, I was ordained by an organization. I've been ordained by two organizations. I joined another organization. They reordained me. I've got two ordinations. But you know what? They are meaningless in the kingdom of God. God is the one who ordains us. The Lord Jesus Christ ordained his apostles, his disciples. The Lord ordains us. The Lord is the one who calls us. The problem in the churches, if you want to get on that, so I started preaching on here, I'm supposed to be talking about my schedule. But the Holy Spirit has arrested me to start preaching. What can I tell you, brothers and sisters? That's what it's all about. It's not about a neat video that, you know, I can have 50,000 subscribers on YouTube and my videos are nice and short and cute and I can have maximum amount of views. But I'd rather please the Lord and be like Noah, only had 8 converts, his immediate family, his sons and daughters-in-laws, and his wife, including himself. There were 8. He had 7 disciples. In the upper room, when the Holy Spirit was given, there was only 120 people. Even though 500 at one time saw the risen Lord. At one time, 500 people saw the risen Lord, the Apostle Paul tells us. So who knows how many people actually saw the risen Lord? More than that. But only 120 were in the upper room 10 days after his ascension into heaven. 50 days after his crucifixion on the day of Pentecost, only 120 people were there. Don't judge by man. Don't judge by the finery of a church. Lots of people are in their flesh. I should have just made a whole other video. People judge by the flesh and not according to the Spirit. They go into these big cathedrals and, ooh, it looks like heaven. Look at all the gold in here. Like me, I've been to the Vatican. I've been to lots of all over Europe. I've been to all the biggest church in the world next to the Vatican is in Cologne, Germany. I've been there. I've been to all those museums. They're museums. All over Europe. I've been to all over the place. When I was in the army, I've been to all lots of these things. I've seen, you know what? Even then, as a backslider, it didn't impress me. I said, look at this museum. Look at this building full of idols. So what? It's all man-made. It's not really heaven. It's not even like heaven. The house of God, the temple of God is in here. In the hearts of the believers is the temple of God. And we are living stones in the temple of God. We're the body of Christ, the temple of God. We are living stones. And then each individual one of us in our heart, if we're born again, the Spirit of the living God indwells us, then we are the temple of God, not some building made with hands. That was the whole argument that the Word of God itself made against building a temple. God made against King David, who wanted to build him a temple. But God let him do it because he loved David. He let him build a temple. God sent the prophet to him and said, you know, the earth is my footstool. You know, who's going to make a building I'm going to dwell in? As we see Stephen repeating that, Acts chapter 7 and 8, we see Stephen repeating those words that the prophet spoke to King David by the Spirit of the living God. God doesn't dwell in houses made with hands. God is in the heart of his people. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I've been doing a little bit of preaching because God led me to. And I'm going to do it and go forward by the grace of God as the Lord leads me. and not be moved by popularity. But I thank God that, you know, there's lots of people that like my preaching. I thank the Lord. It is a blessing if people encourage you. There's no lie about that, brothers and sisters. But it's really only in the flesh. It's only in the flesh. I'm preaching for a one-man audience. By the grace of God. By the grace of God. Let's not be moved by the opinion or swayed by the ideas of men, but by the wisdom of God and His Spirit and His Word. God bless you guys. I'll see you.